all pitching chains presented by ResCom. ResCom Pest Control has been protecting customers' homes and businesses from pests, termites, and rodents for over 30 years. Make your home a pest-free zone. Say hello to ResCom and bye-bye, bugs. So, we'll take a quick break here. We'll get you the new pitcher. We will be right back. Don't go anywhere. You're listening to Rawhide Baseball on Valley Sports Live.
Number 12, Caswell Smith.
Welcome back to Valley Strong Ballpark. Pitching change by ResCom. Presents number 12, Caswell Smith, the right-hander, 6'3", 210 from Canton, Georgia, appearing in his third game in a Rawhide uniform. One of the newer pitchers here on this Rawhide team. He got transferred to Visalia on June 28th. As we have a chance to look at Smith's numbers, doesn't have a decision or an ERA. Five strikeouts, no walks. So the newest pitcher here on the team, we'll get ready to dig in, and he'll face off against Devin Ortiz, who expanded his on-base streak to 14 straight games with a single back in the second inning. The upcoming pitch all the way to Ortiz, and that's a slider that clips the outside corner for strike number one. 84-mile-per-hour breaker there from Smith, and the Georgian is ahead in the count, no balls and a strike. Smith signed as a free agent back in 2022. The delivery all the way from Caswell, and that one will go low for a ball. One ball, one strike. Appeal did go over to the first base umpire, but saying it's safe, so Ortiz remains at 1-1. Runners on second and first. Salas over at first after drawing the walk just before our break. Samuel Zavala at second, and now the upcoming pitch all the way will go high for ball two. Two balls and a strike. Finishing out the California League scoreboard in the bottom of the sixth inning, Modesto currently trailing to Stockton in that game of a score of 5-2. So that's all your scores around the California League, with obviously our game 7-5 at the bottom in the top of the sixth inning. An inside pitch from Smith will go for ball three, three balls and a strike. Look at the California League standings in the second half. Fresno is currently in first. They've only dropped one game in 12 games. With a record of 11-1, Modesto 5-7, Stockton 5-7. So the winner of that Modesto game will end up in control in second place in the Cal North. And now a batter's timeout called by Ortiz as that ball, last pitch, clips the outside corner for strike two, three balls and two strikes. Moving over to the Southern Division, Rancho Cucamonga currently finds himself in second, 6-6, and Inland Empire 7-5. Try to clinch Cal South in the second half. Payoff pitch on the way, runners in motion, and that one just misses low for ball four. And back-to-back walks here for the Storm, and both of them looked very close. We'll see where this one missed from Caswell Smith if you're watching our broadcast. Yeah, just missed the black on that one as well. And here comes Oswaldo Linares, who sent the ball into left center field in his last at-bat. Two away here. Bases loaded once again for the Storm, and Christian sort of preserves the 7-2 ball game as he keeps his body in front of that pitch. One ball, no strikes, two away. You look at Linares, who bats from the right side. Single in the second, strikeout in the third, and a single in the fifth. Upcoming pitch on the way, misses outside for a ball, two balls and no strikes. Smith does not have any bases to give out, so he has to find a way to sit down Leonatis. Batting 163 entering the day. Upcoming pitch on the way, misses outside for ball three. And now in a dangerous spot here for Smith. He'll take his time, steps off the mound, kind of having a quick discussion with himself, wiping off the sweat off of his shoulder and his jersey. One pitch away from making it an 8-2 ball game here in Visalia. A 3-0 pitch on the way from Smith, and that one goes right inside for strike one. Right down Main Street. And the count goes to 3-1 with two away. Waiting on deck is Chase Valentine. 3-1, 2-way pitch on the way from Smith. This one's hit right up the middle of the infield. Diving is Juan Cornell, unable to come up with the grabs. Zavala's going to come around. Ethan Salas will come in to score as well. And it is a two-run RBI from Oswaldo Linares, and he's got his third single of the ball game. And the Storm now lead over the Rawhide 9-2 in the top of the sixth inning. So a pitch there at the bottom of the zone, and Linares drives it right up the middle of the infield, kicks up some dirt off the mound, and a great effort there by Juan Cornell, but just out of reach. And now here comes Chase Valentine to the plate. Looking over at second and Smith, and he'll get ready for the pitch. And that one misses the outside corner for ball number one. One ball and no strikes. So Linares having himself a day, and probably the best defender of the past two nights is Chase Valentine. Check swing, unable to hold up on it. And the count will go to one ball and one strike. So Valentine on the day, 0-2 with back-to-back strikeouts in the fourth and fifth innings. And a walk back in the second. 1-1, 2-way with the insurance added on once again here in the top of the sixth inning. And that one goes to the outside edge for strike number two. Third pitcher used here in the ballgame for manager D. Garner. And it started off with Jose Cabrera. The 1-2 pitch on the way from Caswell Smith. And that one goes outside. Appeal goes down to the first base umpire. And for the third time today, Chase Valentine is going to be sat down swinging. So the Storm.
Caswell Smith on the mound for his second inning of work. He's facing Wyatt Hoffman. He swings the first pitch. Ground ball to the third baseman. Cabral has it on the infield grass. Throw to first in plenty of time for the first out of the inning. The top of the seventh inning with the Storm leading 9-5.
Second baseman,
Charlie Zucchino. Charlie Zucchino bats from the right. He is 1-for-3 today, a two-run double. And he's also struck out twice. It's the first time he's facing Smith. First pitch is a strike on the outside corner. This is Smith's Valley Strong ballpark debut. He joined the Rawhide last week in Rancho. He's not pitched yet this series. 0-1 is a strike on the outside corner. We can give the final pitching line on Montilla, who Caswell Smith came in relief for in the last inning. We'll do it after this pitch, though two misses low. Montilla, an inning and 2/3, 4 runs, 5 hits, 1 walk, and 2 strikeouts. The pitch, swung on, fouled off. Nine to five ball game in the top of the seventh inning. Smith is the third pitcher of the night for the Rawhide. The pitch is low, ball two. We did have a roster move today for the Rawhide, although no additions. The 2-2, high and in ball three. Julio Carrion joined Amarillo today. So the Rawhide currently have 27 active players on the roster. 3 balls, 2 strikes, and the pitch. Just misses a little inside. Ball four. So Aquino draws a one-out walk. Was inside. Sarah did a nice job of framing it to make it look really pretty from up here. Top of the order, Murphy now at the plate. Here's Here's the pitch. It swung on and missed. One down, 0-1 count to the right, to the left-handed hitter, Murphy. Smith delivers, runner takes off, the pitch is high, a double pump from Cerda, and the ball is not in time. Aquino safe at second base. Is unfortunate about that, as that throw was really close, and Cerda did take a second. You can see there on the replay, he pumped once, and it was still a fantastic throw. Aquino safe, though. Stolen base number 6 of the day for the second baseman. Runner in scoring position, one away, the 1-1. Misses out ball 2. Two balls and a strike. Smith delivers. Line drive through into left field, a base hit. Aquino rounds third. He's going to go. Here's a throw from Rojas. It's not in time. Oh, my goodness. Maybe it is. No, he's called safe. Now, Cerda has to throw to second. They have Murphy caught in a rundown. Condicello's going to tag out Murphy. And now Cerda's going to argue with the home plate umpire. And now D. Gardner is out here to have a conversation with the umpire. So here's the thing. It looked like he never touched the plate. He literally flipped over Christian Cerda. I don't know how you physically can touch home plate when you do a flip over it. And D. Gardner is ejected for the first time this season. And quite frankly, it's probably the right time to get ejected for the first time. Well, especially with how hot Cerda got. I mean, D has to come out and protect him. Cerda was probably 2 choice words away from getting ejected. Here's the throw. And you can see, I mean, he never touches the plate. I don't know. I don't know. I mean, if he really wanted to, he could call obstruction instead, because Cerda might have been blocking the plate before he had the ball, but you can't call a guy safe when he never touches home plate. I did think that maybe Cerda didn't tag him. He kind of bumped him with his shoulder, and that's how he flipped over. Then the umpire didn't even give Cerda a chance to try and tag him afterwards, and the fans here are unhappy. They didn't even see the replay, and they're unhappy. Look at the replay another time on Bally Live. I mean, really nice acrobatic play from Aquino, but he doesn't touch home plate. I don't know what else to say. He didn't touch it. He should be out. It should not be a 10-5 ball game. Well, D will be watching the game from the clubhouse. He's been ejected. And I'm pretty sure if the home plate umpire, Spevitt, could eject the rest of the crowd, he would right now. They are letting him hear it. A pitch to Robertson, misses outside, ball 1. So remember, Murphy is out on the rundown that he got caught in. The pitch is a strike, count is 1-1, 2 down, nobody on, a 10-5 ball game. We put a little asterisk on that 10, right? 9-5 game. I apologize for the Storm fans who are listening in right now. The pitch misses low, ball 2, but he didn't touch the plate. You can't, he didn't touch the plate. 2-1 count, 2 down. And the pitch is foul tipped into the glove of Cerda. Two balls, 2 strikes. The pitch from Smith, it's a tapper down the first base side, but Cerda picks it up foul. Two Two balls, two strikes, and two away. Smith delivers. Fly ball towards center. Guzman going back, still going back. Reaches up over his left shoulder on the warning track. And that will end the inning. Well, a run does score in a very controversial play. D. Gardner is ejected, and it is stretch time at Valley Strong Ballpark. 10-5 ball game. You're listening to and watching Rawhide Baseball from the Sun Gazette Press Box on Valley Live.